Today is July 3rd, 2020. This is a special day. This is a day that cemented history. And the thing is, who knows if any of this is true? I don't know if any of the stuff that was on July 3rd actually went on. But being 16 or 15 years old was kind of like, I'm gonna want to know if it's real or not. Let him come. Look at him come, he's coming. Look at him come. Hey, cummy. Hey, cummer. Hey, cummy, cummer. Hey, cummy. Ah, there you are. So the thing with July 3rd being so special, I guess, is that People Under the Stairs released a song called July 3rd. People Under the Stairs, July 3rd, was released in 2000, question in the form of an answer. That's So we heard this song, I don't know, I think it was around 16. So we heard the song when we were roughly like 15, 16.
Young provider.
It changed the fucking game. So 2007, we heard the song, or we've been hearing the song, and we had that idea of like, we have to like know if it's real or not. We have to figure out, because if you haven't heard the song, the verse for Thess, he's talking about a specific area in downtown where he goes, where he's in downtown, he goes to the liquor store, I think, then he goes across the street to rent a movie or rent a video, and then whatever, all that. So the shit
crazy. Rent a video
game. Yeah, so all this crazy shit happens afterwards. But we're fucking, it's so vivid and it's so like, the storytelling is so perfect, you have to like, I don't know, you kind of want to see if that's real or not. And I like when people do that, when people make songs like that, that make it so like, if you're there, you get me? Remember that song was so like great, and we wanted to hear and find out if it was real or not. We map quested it, and we didn't know about Google Maps or if there was Google Maps, and we didn't really know if Google was like that, where you could just type it in and be like, is this fucking real? Like, you know. So we went to. Okay, so yeah, this is where the audio gets a little fuzzy, but if the rumor or if the theory is true, Thess 1 was there on Saturday, July 3rd, 1999, and we ended up going in May of 2008. We got on the bus. We got on two or three buses. I think we got on two buses, and we took a train, and then finally we got off off of the Red Line, and then we walked up because we were like on First and Hobart, I believe, or somewhere near. And then we walked all the way up, and it was kind of like uphill. And then finally, when we were getting to Third and Hobart, we could see the third sign. We were like getting excited. And then as we were going towards it, we see like the video renting spot across the street. And then we turn to the left, and we see the liquor store that he went in through. And then just going through the whole thing and seeing everything so vivid, just exactly how he imagined it. It was there, and seeing it in person finally at that age, you just get so excited, because you couldn't really Google search like if everything was real.
Do you remember that trip at all?
Yeah, basically seeing the movie renting spot and just being like, no way. It kind of like, it adds to the own narrative that he paints in the song. Like, when he's rapping it, you already have it like created in your head. Like, oh shit, that's crazy. I can picture this movie even getting hit and something, like everybody reacting. And then fucking to actually see it, it like adds a whole nother dimension. So that shit was tight.
Yo, check it out. One time for your middle. Kick back, lying. It's the Supreme. Gonna let you know if you drink it on with the team, you know.
This funky little group from the other side of the map.
There goes those flutes.
They came to give us some lead.
They know those were dropping in.
She was babbling about how bad.
He's in the flute and blew your ass last time. We gonna do it like old English 800 on the genuine track. Living living a high life, but still reserved when it's mad. You can say I have a problem, and I say they help me solve. I'm drinking 40s with my nigga dog and older dudes who bought them. It seems I have evolved into this party animal. I be drinking, talking shit, while you pricks take it like, get off the mic and let me babble about the days of old. When I was young and didn't know iced teas could be so cold, all I knew was colors and that stuff my mom made. Nowadays I drink it just like it's the purple Kool-Aid. Bro, go easy on the ice and add a little more Smirnoff. So by the time I reach the bottom, I can be clear wrong. Don't think it's about the end, I say it's about to begin. Take off my shirt, show my belly, offend a few of my friends. You can ask Kid Less, we be doing the most on Melrose with the...
Are you bleeding?
Oh, yeah, I'm bleeding.
Oh my god,
no pickles.
Peppers?
Yeah.
Look at that shit. This is bleeding.
Oh my god. Thank you.
Very vigilant. Very vigilant. This isn't even a sandwich, but you gotta eat this like a hot dog.
Yes.
Put a whole lump of cheese in there. That's its fire, bro.
That was your first bite.
Bro.
Bro, look at that sausage. It's just like...
I know.
Oh, man, just...
Fuck that.
Make the shit look cool. Incidents like that a few. Like the crew drinking Tima or tequila, that's for women. Somebody pass the gin and Powerade. Yo, it's also time to drink. Get off the train.
How do you feel?
Bro. Yeah.
Then like combined with the scenery. Even though like residency of San Pedro is like just real nice, you know, taking it all in.
Those horns are fabulous, man.
With all that being said, with all that stuff that we've done today, just to commemorate the beautiful, beautiful July 3rd, I was going through the hard drives and going through my old camera, and I found the actual footage, photos, and everything from the day that we went to, I don't know, like 10 years ago. So, enjoy.
You know, saying my nigga, shit is fucked up.
Yo, shit,
July, you know, July 3rd, what can you say, but goddamn. Saturday afternoon, drinking cold lemonade, just finished cleaning my room. See, I presumed at that point there was nothing else to do. I took the Jeep down the street and got the 40 of brew. As I'm riding, I decided I'd rent a Genesis game. Turned right on Western, past the Red Line train. Parked my car on the main corner, 3rd and Hobart. Walked across the street to Young's Gaming Video Mart. Was inside, I realized I had forgotten my car. I said peace to the guard, told him I'd go back to my car. Went outside, pushing buttons and the light turns green. Stepping through the crosswalk, now imagine this scene. A tan 88 Dodge minivan didn't stop. He's doing 30 headed for me in the damn crosswalk. Out of shock, I did my best to try and jump back quick. We made eye contact right before I was hit. I jumped up, missing a shoe, shocked and dazed. Blood pouring out my body, traffic stopped both ways. The dude is trying to throw me into his van to take off. I can't even walk straight, let alone fend a mob. He's begging bystanders not to call the police, shit. Giving me $11 cause I just been hit. His sob story lasted till the paramedics arrived. Witnesses crying, saying lucky to be alive. 8 hours later, alone, getting a CAT scan. Trying to go back and understand the randomness of it all. Damn, that's the answer I get. 1 minute get here and the next up.
Born to be wild. Oh, there you go. I was born BBW. I was like, catch up. Yo, woke up kinda mad, although it wasn't late. Today was the day that I thought would be great. Was supposed to spend some time with this girl who thinks she lied. It was like a woman who knew she got blasted on this shit. No, then I see my ex bitch. You know what happened to me too, man? July 3rd, it's a Saturday afternoon.